Elizabeth, thanks for taking the time to talk to us. And we're here in Shankill Castle. This is your home, but you've opened it up this weekend for this beautiful arts festival. Beautiful artwork everywhere. Tell us a bit about it.
Well, it happened kind of organically because Phoebe, my daughter, who lives in London, she wanted to show some of her friends' works here. So it kind of rolled up, it became an organic thing. And so this is why we have so many interesting people, including a couple of people from Norway whom I met when I went there to Edward Munch's studio in the spring. And we have Daphne Astor Warburg and her friends, and their art group is called Centre for Recent Drawing. And we've had a wonderful time because they were very cooperative and we've made it a great show.
Have you had many people coming through the gates?
Yes, yes, it's been a very steady flow, but we're hoping to have more people.
And is this going to turn into an annual event?
Well, it has been an annual event, but I suppose it's more international this year, so we're very happy. We have people from South Africa, from Chicago, from Ethiopia, from all over the place. So it's very entertaining. And we have films and we have etchings and drawings, paintings and sculptures.
So Kilkenny Arts Festival is on this week.
Yes.
What's going on?
Well, everything really. Everyone is trying to show their wares, and that's fair enough. But we have some wonderful films this week. Films by Kevin Hughes, Pat Kenny, Cathy Fitzgerald. Ruben made a tiny film. And, of course, Christy Grotmull, she would have the longest film. And it was shown in the Georges Pompidou Centre in Paris. It runs for half an hour. And it's about the life story of one of Edward Munch's models. And it's worth seeing. It's a beautiful film.
I'm here with Hilary Guise, one of the many artists exhibiting here at Shankill Castle. Hilary, what's brought you here to Kilkenny and to Ireland?
Well, I was invited by Elizabeth Cope, who saw a CD of my work liked it. And she said, you must come, we're going to have an international festival. So.
And where are you from originally?
I was born in Cape Town, South Africa. I was born on a beach. I'm a sea urchin. And the water and the mountains and the colour of Africa and South Africa is always in me. And even though I've been in exile in England for so many years.
Tim Betjeman, your drawings are just the first thing you see when you walk into the entrance hall here at Shankill Castle. How do they come to be here?
Well, I went to the Prince's Drawing School in London with Phoebe a year after Phoebe was there, Phoebe Cope. So she asked me to come along and I was happy to come and see the castle and exhibit here. It's the most beautiful wall I've put my paintings on so far.
We're here in Shankill Castle, County Kilkenny, with Andrew Hewish, and we're surrounded by this very different, very inspiring artwork. Andrew, what brings you here to Kilkenny?
The Copes, who own Shankill Castle each year, have an arts festival. And they invited the resident artists of Centre for Recent Drawing, or C4RD, in London to come and exhibit. And so we formulated a project whereby we went to a primeval forest in Cambridgeshire, in the UK, and it was an experiment in living together in a place quite separate to the exhibition and museum space that C4ID is, where the artists have their residencies, and to see what we could do by way of exploring issues around 19th century romanticism, going to the forest, what kind of truths might be uncovered in the forest while we're there, and what it means to make a work and for the other people to react to the work. So hopefully, as people wander around, they will see links between each of the artist's work and possibly not know which ones whose, and some are collaborations, genuine collaborations as pieces of work of two artists together, and then others are singular works by singular artists.
Joan Edis, you're one of the residents in the Centre for Recent Drawing and surrounded by some of your work here, and it's certainly a pleasure to look at. Tell us a bit about what inspires you.
The materiality of the natural world is something that I find in my work at all times. I'm obsessed with the way things work and the way things work in the world. And depending on how I find materials, sometimes they're found objects, sometimes they're materials I just come across, and I put them together in odd ways, they end up turning into something completely unexpected.
So you work with sound, and you have some sculptural pieces. So do you find that they're all interlinked all the time?
There's a curious relationship that occurs that in some sculptures I've just recently done, for instance these, they were based on a ridge and furrow with a waveform, and I did a sound piece based on the collaboration of all of us in the woods, and the conversations just overlapped on a day-by-day basis, and they ended up in a printout of the audio software to be the same kind of waveform, which I thought was a wonderful kind of serendipity.
Sarah Lederman, you're one of many artists that have made the trip here to Shankill Castle in Kilkenny to exhibit your work. Tell us a little bit about your work.
Well, we did this kind of in the forest, and we decided to go and do a residency all together, the whole C4RD in a forest near Daphne. And we sort of started playing off each other. And I began kind of, every day I was walking past Daphne's work, and I eventually kind of decided that I wanted to do something big and bold, and I started experimenting with watercolours. And it's quite interesting because it's quite different to what I normally do.
Daphne, you're one of the residents in the Centre for Recent Drawing. You've just been on a bit of an excursion.
We have.
And the results of it are seen here. Do you want to explain your work to us?
I will. I actually live on the land where this woodland is. So it's a woodland I know very, very, very well. And I've been working in it alone for 35 years. So I had a thought that perhaps it would be interesting if I was singular, but with my co-workers. So I invited them to come live in the wood for a week and see what we could concoct. And it was a sort of magic week with them, because several people are not really country people. So as you can imagine, just the experience of being enclosed by trees, and it's a primeval woodland, so it has the original seed bed. So it's never, ever been cut.
It's obviously an inspiration to you. How did you find sharing that space with other people after 35 years there on your own?
Hilarious. Hilarious. I mean, one of the joys of it was seeing fear evaporate into joy for me. Because when you come out from the light into the forest, you're in the canopy, and it was in June. So the leaves were just emerging, so all the greens were very, very fresh and very alive. Now, when I'm there alone, I often see deer, badger, fox, forest hare, many, many birds. But when you're there with other people, you make such a racket that all the creatures disappear entirely. But nonetheless, the bumblebees were there. Some of the tree creepers came if you stayed very, very still. But the most profound thing was the relationship that we made with each other in terms of the work we made. And that was very, very inspiring for me.
Alex, we're here in front of one of your beautiful, beautiful paintings. How are you finding the exhibit here?
Well, it's been an amazing experience to show with my colleagues from Centre for Recent Drawing. And actually to see the work together for the first time. We produced this in woods in Cambridgeshire, and now it's in Ireland in a barn, in a gallery space. So it's quite a treat to be able to see the works with everybody else's and up on a wall, you know, in this kind of gallery context.
Are you finding looking at it very different now on a wall as opposed to where it was created?
Yeah, well, it was actually created on the floor. So a lot of the works were painted in response to the woodland. We came into there, and I'd never been into this place before. A lot of my work is actually based in exploring woodlands, but actually in the Arctic. And this was an opportunity for me to actually work in a woods right there. So when I first got into this space, I was trying to work out how to actually paint what was out there. And ended up painting the light coming through the trees. So I've only really seen it rolled up on the floor or unrolled on the floor, and to see it on the wall, there's quite a few instances here which have fed into the work that I've just done recently. So it's been a kind of learning piece as well as a piece that I responded to. So yeah, it's good to see it on the wall.
Mm-hmm.